Lecture, so please turn on your camera, please. Okay, sorry for the lateness. I had a little bit of difficulties, technical difficulties. Okay, so first about the assignment. We already had the assignment, the manual, the last part. So it will be the part for your final exam. Like I said before, your final exam will be your group complete report. So what you need to do, I already give you some advice or revision on your previous works. So you need to revise or amend your previous work and then compile them, all of your previous work, including what you already submitted today, into a single complete report. Okay. I already put on Microsoft Teams the minimal components of your report. Okay, let me share it with you. So okay, so can you put you can see here. So the final report should contain, but not limited to, this following part of your previous work with required revision that if necessary. First, the business process description or narrative. This is the one that you describe the system that you observe. And then diagrams, DFD and flow charts from level from context to level 0 and level 1 if necessary, or level 2, and flow charts. Database tables, database form and reports, both need to have some explanation, okay, for each table. And then user manual. And lastly, this one, I don't think you already the role, responsibility, and works for each member of the group. So for example, who create the tables, who create the forms, and so on and so forth. Okay. Maria Putri, you asked about if you want to collect revision for database form and report assignment, where do I need to collect them? What do you mean? I'm not, I don't.
In previous presentation, my group has a lot of revision, but we don't know where have to collect it, sir.
Okay. Well, you can. Did we have a video meeting on that?
Yes, in lecture
okay.
9.
Okay. Okay. You can replay the video on YouTube about lecture 9 and see what did I say. Because, to be honest, I also forgot what. Well, that's it. But I already give you the revision at that time, so you can replay that video again. Okay.
Okay. Thank you, sir.
No worries. Okay. So you already had the components beside the last part, the role of Egypt. So for the last part, you need to describe what each member has been done in contribution to the final report. Okay, Eleonora, I think you only have yourself to work on, obviously, the last part. So that's probably what you will write on your final report. Okay, that's fine. I already told you. So please, for the final report, do not just copy and paste all the components. You need to put some writing to connect between one component and the other. For example, between the description, narrative, and diagrams, you need to say, you need to explain what's the connection between the narrative and diagrams, for example. Okay. Understood? Anything that you need to ask? Any questions? No? Okay, that's fine.
I want to ask her about data tables.
Mm-hmm. Uh-huh. Okay.
Because we do it on Microsoft Access,
mm-hmm.
so we screenshot it and replace it in the file.
Yes, you can screenshot the tables, but you also need to explain the structure. It means like for table A, column 1, what's the type, what's column 1 for, the data types, the length, things like that.
Okay, thank you, sir.
No worries. Any other question?
Not yet, sir, I think.
Okay, good. Now, if there is no, as usual, if you have any question, you can send me email or drop a line on Microsoft Teams. Okay. So, we finally arrived in our last lecture, which is today is about the continuation of last week. So let me share the slide. Okay, can you see it? Can you see the slide?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay, good. Thank you. Now, so this is a continuation of last week. Topics about system analysis and design. Today we will cover more on the design, implementation, and operation. Not that much because, again, as you probably remember, we will have a specific subject that deal with all of this in detail, which is information system analysis and design. Okay, that you can take that after you pass MIS subject. So now, what's the accountant need, or why as accounting students you learn this, and what would be the role of accountant in system development? See, if you remember that any accounting process will have control element in it. For example, segregation of duties, the record of a transaction. If it's cash transaction, how should you create a journal for that transaction? How much value of transaction should be posted on the journal? How much should be on credit side? How much should be on debit side? Things like that. And as accountant or accounting students or accounting graduates, you have that knowledge. Okay. Programmers can make a lot of different software or application, but only you as account people with accounting knowledge could understand accounting process. Okay. Let me give you one example. How accounting logic or accounting process should help. Many years ago, one of my had a student that she investigate automotive shop belong to her relatives and make it her thesis subject. So thesis topic for her undergraduate thesis. So what she saw was the automotive shop already had accounting software for inventory and for sales and also for purchasing. Okay. And she saw that the balance of inventory in that software was minus. The value of inventory was minus. In accounting, as far as I remember and as far as I know, there will be no negative balance of an account. Okay. Especially with inventory. The lowest value of inventory should be zero, not negative. Okay, so she investigated the practice. Apparently, that stemmed from the two part. You know, inventory was reduced by sales and will be increased by purchase of new inventory. So what happened was the sales department updated the sales and updated the inventory quite often. As soon as they finish a sales transaction, they immediately reduce the amount of available inventory. So if they say if they sell 1,000 units, they immediately subtract the inventory by 1,000. Unfortunately, the purchasing department did not update the inventory data immediately. So for example, if they buy 2,000 units of inventory, they didn't immediately update it or add the amount of available inventory by 2,000. Sometimes they didn't even record it new purchase and update the inventory level. So if the inventory, say they still have 500 inventory on record, but on the warehouse, the physical count of inventory is not 500, say 2,000. And then when the sales department sell 1,000 unit, because there are 2,000 unit in the warehouse, they can sell 1,000 because the order was smaller than the amount inventory they have. So if they have 2,000, they sell 1,000, that's possible. Okay. However, because on the record, on the inventory system, there were only 500. So when they subtract 1,000 to that, what they had was minus 500. Mathematically, that's correct. Okay. But from accounting perspective, that's incorrect. Okay. And I could not say the brand, but the accounting software used by that automotive shop was one of the popular accounting, until now, popular accounting software in Indonesia. So the programmer of that accounting software didn't understand accounting process. They understand the mathematics, but so what should be done if accounting person involved in the design? And this is for, they remember when we discussed the revenue cycles, check the inventory. If the inventory record is not sufficient for order for the customer, they need to inform the purchase department to buy new inventory. Okay, so the software should prevent sales if the amount or the value of sales is bigger than the available inventory. So for example, if the inventory record show 500 and they want to sell 1,000, the transaction should be rejected by the system. Okay. And the purchasing department should update the inventory amount from 500 to 2,000 in order for the sales transaction could be processed. Okay, so that's how accounting could contribute to system development, and also obviously measuring cost and benefit. Is the proposed new system have bigger benefit than the cost? That's the purpose. Okay. Just a moment. I had this difficulties. I have technical difficulties. Just a moment. Okay. Okay, sorry about that. Mine was suddenly stopped working. Okay, let me continue that. Okay. Okay. So, another role that accounting graduate could contribute to system development is to define the business problem, especially in accounting domain. Okay. Programmer might not understand how a business process being carried out. They might not understand the requirements of a cash transaction. What's the difference between cash transaction and credit transaction? Why people or why customer need to have a credit limit, for example, then you can explain to that. Okay. And this especially true, for example, in order to create application for taxation, to calculate income tax, to calculate, you need to understand how income tax being calculated. Now, so that's how could you contribute to the. Okay. So again, we'll start now with the conceptual system design. Okay. Now remember that most system today could be bought instead of built. So a lot of software being available in the market. Okay. You can just buy one instead of building, and by buying, you can save a lot of time. Okay, let me return to this. If you buy a software, it's much faster, and in most cases, much cheaper than build the system yourself. Okay. And plenty of software available now. You need accounting software, take a pick. You can pick a software for accounting that run on your mobile phone. If you look at some of the cafe, they have a sales system that can run on tablet or even smartphone. Okay. There are some accounting system that need powerful computers like the one that the bank had, okay, or any other big companies. However, because we have so many options to buy the software, we still need to define what kind of software we need that can be used for the company. So for example, if Pertamina need accounting software, they definitely could not use the version that can be run from a mobile phone. Pertamina has a lot of data that could not handled by just single mobile phone. They need a powerful computer. I have few students currently that working on their thesis. and they work on finding the appropriate software for small business. And it's not easy. A lot of constraint, a lot of different requirement that need to be that need to be fulfilled. For example, with small business, obviously, funding is a problem. Okay. Even with large enterprise like Pertamina, there's always limitation on how much money they could spend on a system. Okay. So that's it. That's one of the problem. Okay. So okay, if you build the system, sorry, if you develop a new system, you can see to evaluate the setup. Can you buy it, or should you build it yourself, or ask somebody else to build for you? Okay. If you need to buy, even with buying or developing in-house or asking somebody outsourcing, asking somebody to build it for you, we need still to specify what kind of system we need to develop or we need to have. Okay. If it's for buying, then we need to specify what kind of software we should buy. Okay. I will skip this. Okay, the detail will be covered in information system design and analysis. Then prefer design specification. Physical design, you already did this with output design of the report, design of the database. Okay, for example, for the output, who will use the output, when is needed, what decision will it facilitate, things like that. Output medium should be appear on the screen, printed, or any others. The format should be table, narrative, or graphic. Okay. Should be pre-printed or location, how to access it, things like that. Okay. Input design, the forms, program designs. You haven't done this, but some of you already design a query, which is the closest thing to programming. Procedure design, this is how to use it, and control the site. This and goes to goes to implementation. Okay, so with implementation, what are the work that need to be done? First, developing a plan. In business, all the activity should be planned. Okay. There's no such thing as impulsive action. Okay. They should be planned. So for activity as big as implementation, it should be planned ahead. Then preparing the site, preparing the probably the building, the rooms for that system. Installing, testing hardware and software, and then selecting and training personnel. Your user manual will be used for training later on, and completing documentation, and not to forget to test the system. This is all the activities. testing the system have two different purposes. First is to make sure that the system will perform as intended. So if the system should be able to provide report on daily sales, can the system generate report on daily sales? If the system should be able to send notification to customer about their order, the system should be able to do that. That's the first purpose for testing. The second is to test the limit of the system. For example, if the system was designed to handle 1,000 transactions, can the system actually handle 1,000 transactions? And if we find out that the system can handle 1,000 transactions, how about if we increase the number of transactions to 2,000 twice? Can the system still handle it? If it's break, then we understand the system will not able to handle 2,000 transactions. Okay, so everything under 1,000, everything under 2,000 is fine, but more than 2,000, it will break. So we know the limit. Also, we test for security, how secure the system is. Okay, it should be secure enough. There is no system that 100% secure. Okay, even when we design the system as secure as possible, there is always hole or weaknesses that can be exploited by other. For example, the user or the people who run the system. People or human is the weakest link of any system. So for example, password. People often forget their password or they make password that easily guess. Recently in the US, there are attack on the fuel pipeline that creating fuel shortage in the US. Apparently, it was started with the hacker exploited the weaknesses in a system, and usually it's the people. Okay, so the test for security is good. Okay, and even with rigorous and comprehensive testing, there is always a possibility that the system will find a condition or event or anything that wasn't being tested. So for example, if you see Windows, Microsoft Windows, okay, Microsoft already conducted thousands and thousands of testing with different computers, with different set of devices, with different set of printer, different set of monitor, mice, keyboard, and everything. But still, there will be people with certain hardware configuration that won't run or having trouble with Microsoft Windows. Now, a few months ago, Microsoft released an update to Windows. Apparently, this update, although it's being tested, I installed the update in my computer and there was no problem. But a lot of people reporting that those update make some printers fail to print. Okay, so even though Microsoft tested that software, the new version of Windows rigorously, apparently something could be wrong. Okay. So, and then conversion, we already discussed this conversion. And lastly, the last part of software development life cycles is operation and maintenance. The system that we develop will be used for daily operation. Operation and maintenance is the majority of system development life cycles is the biggest proportion. So for example, if you develop a system for a year, the system could be in operation and maintenance for more than 3 years. Okay. In fact, a lot of system right now still use the system that developed in the 70s or 80s. Department of Defense in the US, they use technology from the 70s for computers that control nuclear missiles. So they still use a computer from the 70s for nuclear missiles. Boeing 747 still use technology from the 80s for their onboard computers. Okay, so some system could live quite long. Okay. And why is that? There is this saying in business, if it's not broken, don't fix it. So if the system still working fine, still could fulfill the need of a company, never touch or do anything with the system, let it run. Okay. But if the system have possibility that in the near future could not fulfill the need of a company, then you might need to build a new system. But if it's still working fine, it will perform just fine, and it will fulfill the need of the company in the future, don't touch it. Okay. If it's not broken, don't fix it. Okay, so that's the operation and maintenance. Okay, so this is the proportion. About 30% of the work in system development take place during the development. 70% is in maintenance. That's why when you create a system, you need to consider the operation and maintenance. How easy the system being maintained. And one of the key in system maintenance is the documentation. For example, if a software or is an application having printing error, then a good documentation will show where which part of that system dealing with printer or printing. Then if there's error with printing, we can directly go to the part that deal with printing to fix whatever problem there. Okay, that's a good documentation. And that's if it's hardware, for example, how easy to fix. I had this rather unpleasant experience with iPad, for example. I bought iPad Air 2 in 2014. I bought an extra warranty, so instead of 1 year, I had 2 years. So it's 2016 until 2000. In 2017, my iPad has had problem with the charging. So I brought that to authorized Apple service, and what they said was they could not fix it. Okay, they offered to replace. With because I was out of warranty, I need to pay for the replacement. So they say they offer to replace my broken iPad Air 2 with the new iPad Air 2. I have to buy in short. I have to buy new iPad iPad Air 2. So I brought that to other service center that was not authorized. Why? Because Apple designed their system to be replaced completely rather than fixed. That's what I learned. Okay. So imagine that if you design a system that could only be replaced instead of fixed in the future, that will create a lot of problem because 70% time is spent here. Okay. Okay. So that's for today. Any question? Any question about the topics? Okay, so before I ended our session, what we learn in accounting information system is how all the accounting process that you already and will learn in financial accounting could be supported by technology. Okay. Later, after you finish this subject, you will continue to MIS. Okay. The prerequisite of MIS is you to pass the accounting information system. In MIS, you will learn how to manage IT resources in a company. Okay, so it's different subject from accounting information system. And the difficulties with MIS is while accounting information system doesn't really change much in the last 20 years or so, management information system change quite rapidly. Okay, every month even. Okay, so that's the thing. So, and then after MIS, you can take the information system analysis and design. Okay. Any questions? Okay. Before I close this session, remember. Prepare your final report, compile all your works and revise it and make it one single report, and you can submit that report as a group for final exam. Okay, I didn't have the final exam schedule yet, but I think you can start your work from now. So by the time for your submission, you already have a final version of your report to be submitted. Okay. So that's it for. Maria, go ahead.
Sir.
Yeah.
We should submit it in PDF or documents. Or Word.
Either way. I'll set up that you can submit both. Look, I'll set the submission system to be able to accept any document. Okay, but remember, you need to submit a document that I can open. For example, if you submit Adobe Photoshop document, I don't have Adobe Photoshop, so I could not open it. Okay, but if you need to submit, for example, if for budget you need Microsoft Excel, you can submit it in Microsoft Excel. If for your form and report you need to submit in Microsoft Access, please do so. Okay, so I will not limit the submission. Okay, but remember, it should be I should be able to open your file submission. Okay.
Thank you, sir.
Any other question? Okay, so thank you for attending this class. I'm sorry that we could not meet in person. Okay, for me it's quite difficult, and I believe you also have your own difficulties. However, under the circumstances, I think we did our best. Good luck with all your study, and see you in other class, not in the same subject. Okay. So have a nice day and see you next time.
Thank you, sir. Have a nice day.
Thank you, sir.